Welcome to our this session on HART protocol. Till now, we have covered RS-232, RS-485, 20 milliampere current loop and Modbus. If you have not gone through my those sessions, do watch the same for understanding different industrial communication protocols. In our current session, we are going to study about HART protocol basics. Before I start, I request you to share your valuable feedback about this session in the comment section. For a session on any topic of your choice, you can let me know in the comment section. Now, without any further delay, let's start. Nowadays, in industrial automation, field instruments directly communicate with the PLC and they are transmitting the recorded values as well as diagnostic data using digital communication techniques. These types of communication would not have happened if smart instrumentation protocols were not designed. HART is one such smart instrumentation protocol. HART, Highway Addressable Remote Transducer Protocol, is a typical smart instrumentation field bus protocol. HART was designed and developed by Rosemount. It's an open standard, so any manufacturer can use this standard. And that is why almost all manufacturers create HART devices for field application. HART has become so popular that process automation cannot be thought without HART protocol. HART protocol is a hybrid analog and digital protocol. HART protocol operates in a hybrid 4 to 20 milliampere digital fashion. In contrast to other field bus protocol which are purely digital in nature. Here, this hybrid 4 to 20 milliampere digital is most important. HART protocol uses frequency shift keying FSK technique to superimpose digital information on analog signals on the same 4 to 20 milliampere lines. It uses two frequencies of 1200 Hz and 2200 Hz as digit 1 and 0 respectively, both of 1 milliampere peak to peak. Here a question arises that if an additional analog signal is sent with the existing 4 to 20 milliampere signal, will it not distort or corrupt the actual value being transmitted on the 4 to 20 milliampere scale? Well, the additional analog signal won't affect the 4 to 20 milliampere signal as the average value of the 1200 and 2200 Hz analog sinusoidal signal will be 0 and thus 4 to 20 milliampere signal will be unaltered. What is the advantage of HART protocol? The advantage of HART protocol lies in its cost effectiveness. HART protocol uses the same two existing wires which are being used for 4 to 20 milliampere signal transmission from the field instrument for additional parameters and diagnostic values. Thus, additional capabilities are added without any new wiring cost. HART protocol working modes. HART protocol works in two modes, point-to-point mode and multi-drop mode. In point-to-point mode of HART protocol, the polling address of the smart device is set at 0. Now, the field device will send the field value in the range of 4 to 20 milliampere signal and additional information will be sent using FSK signal in form of 1200 and 2200 Hz signal. In multi-drop mode of HART protocol, a unique address is assigned to all the connected smart devices on the network. Actually, the moment we set address of a device other than 0, mode changes to multi-drop mode. In multi-drop mode, the smart device sets its output at a constant value of 4 milliampere and starts communicating digitally only at a data transfer rate of 1200 baud. In this multi-drop mode, all the devices does not communicate simultaneously. Instead, they communicate one at a time in poll response mode. The master polls each of the device with the required information, and only the intended device responds with the required information. There have been many revisions in the HART protocol, and with the latest revision 7, 64 devices could be connected in a multi-drop mode. What is a HART communicator? HART system includes a handheld control device which could work as a second master, which is known as HART communicator. The HART communicator has keys for input and a local display for displaying the required information. It's portable and battery operated. The HART communicator is used to read, write, range and calibrate devices on the bus and can be easily carried to the field for temporary communications. Is 250 ohm resistor necessary for HART protocol? Yes, a resistance is necessary for reception of data using the HART protocol. While the resistance is necessary, exact 250 ohm is not the necessity. For proper functioning of a HART current loop, the total loop resistance, that is precision resistor plus wire resistor, must fall in the range of 250 ohm to 1100 ohm. There is a very famous and popular reasoning related to DCS, which is many DCS uses 1 to 5 volt signal for recording of data from field. A 4 to 20 milliampere signal transmitted by the field device could be converted into a 1 to 5 volt signal using a 250 ohm resistor. While this logic for conversion of milliampere signal into volt signal for reading in DCS is completely correct, that is not the reason behind use of 250 ohm in HART current loops. Now a question arises, what is the reason behind use of a 250 ohm resistor in HART current loops? A power supply is a low pass capacitor filter, and it simply filters out any analog signal, considering it as a ripple. If a resistor is not used in a HART current loop, the analog signal 1 milliampere peak to peak being transmitted from the smart transmitter will be filtered out by the power supply filter. When a resistor is added in series with the transmitter, the analog signal 1 milliampere from the transmitter generates a voltage across the resistor added, and the HART communicator starts receiving the FSK signals. Now from this it is clear that addition of resistance is necessary for HART current loop. The resistance could be any value such that total loop resistance is in between 250 ohm to 1100 ohm, and sufficient power is being delivered to the transmitter for proper functioning of the same. Features of HART technology. Diagnostic data may be transmitted by the field device, like self-test results, out-of-limit alarms, preventive maintenance alerts, etc. Field instruments may be rearranged remotely through the use of HART communicators. HART communicators may be used to force field instruments into different manual modes for diagnostic purposes. For example, forcing a transmitter to output a fixed current so as to check calibration of other loop components. Field instruments may be programmed with identification data. With this, I conclude my session on HART protocol. Hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, press the bell icon and like button. Your feedback are really helpful for me, so do share what you felt about this session. Thanks for watching. We'll be back soon with my another session. If you need a session on any particular topic, do let me know in the comment section. Thank you.